Sometimes a game falls under the radar, even though it deserves more attention. These are usually indie games, but ever since Stardew Valley, I've realized this is one of the richest veins in gaming today. So I decided to create a video series called Have You Considered Playing? Or Hiccup, featuring cool games you might not know about. And now, without further ado, have you considered playing Ghost of a Tale? Come on, you knew that was coming. You saw the episode title, right? Now, I'll tell you, I always feel reluctant telling people about a game preview. In the past, I've had a very pessimistic attitude about game previews because the developer is essentially selling you on an unfinished game under the promise that it will continue getting content until it is. But then, I started seeing these very ambitious titles that were striving for something great and offered gamers an early build for a fraction of the price. The best examples I have of this are Subnautica and We Happy Few, high-quality games that started as game previews before they became full-fledged games. And We Happy Few is now a full-release title with a matching price tag, making me wish I bought it early. Anyway, Ghost of a Tale is a game preview. Go figure. Like the titles I mentioned earlier, the presentation here is not what you'd expect from what we normally consider an indie game. Atmosphere and world building is quite nice. The story revolves around Tilo, who is basically a mouse bard. Trapped in the sprawling fort Dwindling Heights, he has been imprisoned by rats for, I don't know, probably being a mouse bard. Now Tilo has to escape his confines and find his wife Meera. Along the way, you meet a cast of interesting characters and explore a beautifully realized fantasy setting. Ghost of a Tale dares to be an actual stealth game. Most modern games will talk about their stealth mechanics, which equates to sneaking about until that fails and you need to start shooting everything in sight. Tilo is not a fighter. The best he can do is temporarily knock out guards with bottles or grease pots. He's not shanking anyone, so you have to rely on stealth, agility, and speed to get past guards. You can also use sticks to distract enemies or set off the bear traps someone just decided to leave lying around. As you steal keys and pull levers, you unlock new pathways to traverse Dwindling Heights, which is good because there's a fair amount of backtracking and collection quests. It is fun to find all the hidden passageways that make your journey quicker. You also collect a series of costumes that augment your stats, and open some dialogue options with certain characters. When I said game previews were unfinished games, this is no different. The current build on Xbox One ends when you head to the catacombs, but there's still so much to enjoy before that point. And the game feels like such a passion project, I have no doubt that there is much more to the game that will be released in time. Right now, you can get this game in its current state for $20. That's the same price of most game previews before they raise the price as a full release title. So if this sounds interesting to you, you might consider playing it. Also, Tilo is the cutest mouse, and he has a lute. I mean, how can you not?